back into it. We saw this before.
Three, two, one, go!
Actually, reversing SVP quite a bit, so...
In a very good sense.
What the fuck? He gets it all the way to the side. It was a Smash 4 combo. He just gets you were right. Just carry the momentum straight up and takes it. But that's not good. Doing the same thing to Fade Bowser. Really fishing for those guys. What an absolute brilliant move. Just gets the reset on the combo. Just gets the stop. Really showing you that even though this creeper isn't played very much, it definitely has some stuff. Again, that, just that up air combo being so good just to reverse the situation. Yeah, it's what, 1 minute down? Both of them down somewhat. Just, we saw that first kill come out in the first 30 seconds, and we saw the second kill come out in the first 30 seconds. Oh, I guess in the next 30 seconds. I think, you know, like, it was kind of like the thing we were talking about before, where if you already have played a little bit with the other player, then the match definitely becomes different. Because now you're not trying to, like, drop combos to my team, which is leading to last match. See, what a reset from SVP over there. Able to just... Yeah. Yeah, definitely far more explosive game than last. Their up air again, that could be so handy. Last time was down throw up air, this time was up throw up air. Just up air. Hey, it ain't broken, don't fix it. And he gets another reach time. That's probably gonna kill right there. He's out again. 4 minutes and 45 seconds, and we're last off. Being so aware of that, that science back from the ledge, just gets exactly about that incumbent. This is the grab. He just gets past, gets a couple, almost gets the reset there, getting out of that situation super well. He's just nicely shielding their player defensively, but is able to close it out almost. That splat bomb just covering side back to ledge, almost able to get the lock. Great use of dash grab. Having really good, like, ledge compression, forcing SVP to pick up the option. As he just gets out, does I think it's up air, and then holds it for a single second. And there's Bruce, and he gets out red! Forward smash. The classic boop de boop takes the first round. SVP not letting Fate repeat itself. I didn't seem like either one of them was really struggling on stage. I mean, obviously, clearly from the match, they both just wrapped out immediately, but it really just did come down to that last match.
3, 2, 1, go!
Just the intimidation stands over here. Wow, did they... Was that... What, like, for this trial? Or is that what? It's the stalemate. The ledge bank immediately jumps out of the ledge bank with the right key to its abilities. He gets kind of low profile things. Out of areas. Almost get the spacing on that, but get reversed for protect up thrash. I like that SPP waited for the guns to sort.
would have come out, and then... We're getting a nice little jump read, but hey, XP here, like, not quite. Let's go back to center stage. Speaking up, but I wouldn't say by too much. Good space, but... Not the percent for the good enough for the opposite dash. That was really good because, like you were saying before, that and I guess he was waiting for that adaptation from Fade and just absolutely ready for that. Barely makes it past. SVP trying to tell me he just does not deserve the first blood. He's not getting better. I saw them take that first stop in the set just so quickly, so if Big does know what to do, just stop it. Again! Definitely making this look like a, damn, like a 10-game situation. I guess both of the players want to play on a metal. This is just non-stop. It's been really short games, but really good ones.
3, 2, 1, go!
I'm interested in seeing how they're picking up on each other's habits. It doesn't seem like either one of them has like a pretty glaring one that another is capitalizing on. I really like the way they're playing space with us. Oh, is this a kill? Oh no, he gets a good DI there, but he gets a backer and pushes him right off stage. Oh, gets the witch timer! Right to the up smash. What was that? Okay, that fade for the... Yeah, and set them up for a really good lead. It's a really good lead. Yeah, really just using the fact that they have a lead to their advantage. Making SP is tough for them. Unlike the last game, it seems like Fade is really comfortable just sort of using the fact that they have advantage. Not quite gonna kill pushing quite far off the neither of them have been able to get super hard edge guards on each other just due to them having a few options and the operator coming back in. It has just been relentless this entire couple sets just like confirm stops. Not really making too many mistakes. Not letting each other shoot. Just backing up. And we get a nice little combo over here. Drags us all the way to the side up. 51-8. A good percent lead over here. Any strong game will be enough to stop. But he has a good lead to work with, and he puts it in. set right there. It takes him off stage again. Oh, not quite enough. I think the SVP adapted in the middle just to avoid getting killed over there. He's really trying to just make SVP hold the L here. Did he wait out an air dodge or was it? Oh, within the same job? Oh, wow. Oh, that's really good. Combos. Unfortunately, Ryu doesn't get too much else off of that. Just that one. Waiting on the first hit. Good way to put that rapid jab and make it look safe. Good ledge move there just to get out of there. Fate doesn't need too much more percent, so she's more than happy just to play neutral here. Ooh, goes for the witch time read on that backer, but it's coming right after the witch time. Oh, getting the down tilt. Confirm over there. Keeping Fate out there for so long. Burns every single. Yeah, but it's almost like he used the ink like a flood. Fate went nice and safe. It's untackable. Hey, yeah, unable to get the reset. Backer's back. Yeah, I think. Yeah, I think people, it's hard for you as the player who is a high percent to remember that, you know, your legend Vincent is gonna run out when you're already worried about making it back to stage. So yeah, it being really well, using the bat within just to really get out of that match and send out rapid jab as well. That told me this, that a lot of players say that your timing matters more than your option, and just having less time to work with is that one was a good thing. Yeah. Much safer game this time. This is looking more reminiscent of the first couple sets we saw from them, since I guess now both of them are respecting each other's options and we both have at least one. Ooh, gets the question over here with this kill. Not quite, but it's 50% combo. Barely this time, it over there. Don't know where their FPP just reacted to it. Ooh, good 2-frame over there. Gets it out of there. Yeah, SVP making it look like it's a lot more active than it is. Fade, she's having a hard time just taking this first one. Technically being a lot more collected, and I like that here, just playing around Bayo's options rather than trying to play it to their own. Oh, Oh, good back air over there. Just unexpected. Just waits for the option, tells him to come out and execute.
As the timing and the option, just automatically on
it. Good spacing by Faye. Just unpunishable by distance. See. Ooh, gets the forward smash out of the perfect range. Way to get back on stage with that man. Who tries to do it again in the back of the end, but as you can see, to be aware of that time. Yeah, you were right about that animation. You can mess you up a little bit just because you're going to hand that. Going all the way down there, can SP even make it back? And good play by Faye. Last off, very much looking for a kill over here. Unfortunately, those combo starters just don't need any kills. Oh, gets the back out once more. Breathing, making good use of that ledge timer. Good grabs it straight to 53, but Faye almost clapping back with a combo of their own. Not able to get fair to fair though. Good landing options over there. Ooh! Good stagger. Yeah, it's kind of like Bowser's fire, but it goes even higher.
Yeah.
Ooh, got the forward smash! Just out of nowhere! Just calls it out absolutely. He's out of the bracket. Alright, so are we back to all?
Yeah, it's an all.
That's fine.
3, 2, 1, go!
All right. Another slow start. Both of them really trying to push me to get those folks in. Either of them to get big damage off of one hit. A lot of hop. A lot of ground games.
Oh my goodness.
Ooh, hops over the down there. Almost gets the upper control, but not quite good enough. Not able to do too much off that there. You gotta respect Bayo's options. Gets the up. Yeah, that's a confirm right there. It's insane that they can kill just from having a grab. It's basically trying to kill. Stop leaving or pull on something. I don't decently for us, but I can still see the one that comes out. Yeah, we've seen both of them even just within the grand finals itself make some really good comebacks. almost gets the tackle. Ooh, calls out the jump, but maybe that's not all that's gonna make it back. Both of them just opting to see the jump back. Yeah, it definitely seems like Edgeguarding is more of a character check than it is. I don't know.
Yeah, like against little Macrobin,
and if your Power Mythra means like if you're against Power Mythra, then I guess like that might be one of their worst weaknesses, is something that you go for. But Ledge being definitely more of a prevalent part of the game in general. Vay just keeping SVP in the wall. Really making it out for him. Good damage, but almost gets the back there. Ooh, we can get all the way back to stage on the platform. Right back to center stage. Fade with rage right now, but kill the back of me.
We'll come out to get that grab.
And it definitely means that if you die first, you're a boy, you can definitely back up and set up the next one. Ooh, stabbing. It's just very easy. It's going to be on the side of the stage.
So it sort of looked like Sora and Aerolus.
It really did. That's when he got the idea. I wonder if she can do anything with that. That's the one, two, and then I'm smashing. You're smashing that. And then that's confirmed! Oh, it doesn't kill them! Let's get this item. Barely getting out of here. Definitely needs a kill right here to bring this back. Might be over for Vader. That's gonna do it. Oh! Falls out with the SDI! Ooh, which time is the stop the bomb that he's able to flash? And that's the game out there. Oh, but it's not! She holds on. Gets the confirm. Oh, that's like 200% for anything else. Ooh, this tech we could do. Locking SVP on stage. Able to get SVP with those lingering hits. Almost like a snake bomb.
Yeah, I think
the bomb would be more than that. Oh, maybe it would have been a little bit more intense. Is it? Oh, forward throw is not going to do it.
Yeah, not going to
land, I think. Oh, looking for that witch time, but no grab the mental living this time. Yep, yeah. That gets it. What a big back for picking it up for that past loss in Wares.
Start the battle.
Alright, monitor going out, so we're gonna have to just look at the screen. Is there any way to make this bigger? Face cam just all out of whack. Yeah, it's a little small, but we'll make do. Maybe if I... Yeah, that's better. Yeah, we don't super need to see our faces, I'll just... Alright, no! Is there any way to make the side bigger? Not that I know of, so... I'm gonna hold off on the transitions because I don't want to forget which side they're on. Yeah, that's great.
Okay.
Oh, you just got your hands. Oh.
Oh, yeah.
That's the last frame that we have. Alright, so this side is our program history. Gotcha. That game's good. Alright, we're starting. Definitely been really close every single game, but SVD is just able to inch up and on a lot of these. These last ones. Honestly, I think that the throne of the Hunger has been so useful for SVD just because we need this massive impact on some of the stocks and the people. Definitely having to rely on backer a lot. But in terms of getting an early percent, basically, he's just doing so well. Gets that early ink. Again, I'll be being so good just to pressure shield and get out. Not able to get too much of a conversion today, just getting a lot of options here against the up leap. No high damage out of there. Up tilt, but unable to get it. high 70s, waiting for one of those kill options. Dylan does get the ledge jump, holds in his ledge, just doesn't get the punish off that. Go to air dodge, but put it off of it, and it's tough. Oh, doesn't kill though. I shared the kill screen, but just gonna do it here. Oh, another kill screen, does he make it? And it's not. It's an SVP 2 up or 3 up. Yeah, I think what's happening is just, I think SVP just gets the kill first and then gets the kill second. Yeah, it's been really just back and forth on the kills, but they definitely barely not being able to get there. All right, SVP making it all the way back from the reset. Just putting on a show here just really well. Just needs one game. It's kind of like having a stop lead in the sense that you are waiting for Baker to try to close it out, I guess, rather than you having to do too much. You can take some risks that might potentially pay off, but you don't really have to do too much. But
a lot of the more like high risk coverage situations are a little better.
3, 2, 1, go!
Sure. Absolutely great reset on us. Just holding the bait back. mistake with Mega Shield Burn. Last time they usually went for the forward smash, just to try and break the shield, just back out of there, just to get out of there. Just really safe. Oh, okay. Oh, an other down throw up air to close it. Yeah. I will say they played so well around that grab.